Today we are going to study the combination of capacitors. The effect on the capacitance if two or more capacitors are connected in series or in parallel. Capacitors in series. Figure shows capacitors C1 and C2 combined in series. The left plate of C1 and the right plate of C2 are connected to two terminals of a battery and have charge Q and minus Q respectively. It then follows that the right plate of C1 has charge minus Q and the left plate of C2 has charge Q. Thus, in series combination, charges on the two plates plus minus Q are the same on each capacitor. The total potential drop V across the combination is the sum of potential drops V1 and V2 across C1 and C2 respectively. It means that these are the two capacitors which are connected in series. So whatever is the charge on this plate plus Q, the same charge will be on the another side of the plate, and similarly the plus Q charge on the left hand side of this capacitor C2 and minus Q on right hand side of the C2 means both the plates will have the same charge. So V is equal to V1 plus V2 is equal to Q upon C1 plus Q2 upon C2. That is, V upon Q is equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2. Now we can regard the combination as an effective capacitor with charge Q and potential difference V. The effective capacitance of the combination is C is equal to Q upon V, and hence 1 upon C is equal to 1 upon C1 plus C2. In general, formula for effective capacitance of a series combination of n capacitors: 1 upon C is equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3 and so on. So when the two or three or more capacitors, they are connected in series, then the resultant capacitance will be given by this expression. Now, capacitors in parallel. Figure shows two capacitors arranged in parallel. In this case, the same potential difference is applied across both the capacitors, but the plate charges plus minus Q1 on capacitor 1 and the plate charges plus minus Q2 on the capacitor 2 are not necessarily the same. That means Q1 is equal to C1V and Q2 is equal to C2V. The equivalent capacitor is one with charge Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 and potential difference V. So Q is equal to CV is equal to C1V plus C2V and C is equal to C1 plus C2. So the general formula for effective capacitance C for potential the parallel combination of n capacitors follows similarly. Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Qn, that is CV is equal to C1V plus C2V plus CnnV, which gives C is equal to C1 plus C2 plus Cn. So when the two or more capacitors, they are connected in parallel, then the resultant will be given as C is equal to C1 plus C2 plus Cn. Here you have to keep in mind that you have studied already in previous classes that when resistors are connected in series or in parallel, when resistors are connected in series, then resultant R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus Rn. Here the same is in the case for the parallel capacitors or capacitors in parallel. So when the capacitors are connected in parallel, then result will be same as the resistors are connected in series. So here it is interchanged. Now let us discuss a problem. A network of four is connected to a 500 volt supply as shown in figure. You have to determine the equivalent capacitance of the network and the charge on each capacitor. Here we have to note the charge on a capacitor is the charge on the plate with higher potential and opposite to the charge on the plate with lower potential. So this is the figure in which we have four capacitors, that is C1, C2, C3 and C4, and the battery, this is the 500 volt. So we have to find the equivalent capacitance of this network. So first of all, in the given network, C1, C2 and C3 are connected in series. C1, C2 and C3, all these are connected in series. So we will apply the formula for the series combination. So for C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C3 as given in the question, 10 microfarad. The resultant will be the sum of all the these three using the above formula. The network has C dash and C4 connected in parallel. Thus the equivalent capacitance C of the network is C is equal to C dash plus C4 is equal to 10 by 3 plus 10 is equal to 13.3 microfarad. So let us once again that first these three, they are connected in series. So we will use the series combination formula. Then the resultant of these three, if it is denoted by C dash, it is connected to C4 and in parallel. And then we use the formula for the parallel combination and we get the result, which is equal to 13.3 microfarad. Now we have to find the result charge on each capacitor. Now clearly from the figure, the charge on each of the capacitors C1, C2 and C3 is the same as they are connected in series. So let the charge on C4 be Q dash. Now since the potential difference across AB is Q upon C1, across BC is Q upon C2, across CD is Q upon C3. So we have now the charge on C4 be here C1, C2, C3 have the same charge because they are connected in series, and C4 it is connected in parallel, so it will have a different charge, that is Q dash. So potential difference across AB, since they are connected in series, so potential difference will be different. On this will be Q upon C1 across second capacitor, Q upon C2 and across the third capacitor, Q upon C3. So Q upon C1 plus Q upon C2 plus Q upon C3 is equal to 500 volt, and also Q dash upon C4 is equal to 500 volt because this fourth C4 and this the resultant of these three, they are connected in parallel. So in parallel the potential difference is same. So this gives the given value of the capacitance. Now if we solve this, we will get the result. Q is equal to this one and Q dash is equal to this one. So in this way we can solve the various problems. Now these are the assignment for you, that is in first question, three capacitors of capacitance 9 picofarad are connected in series, then you have to find the total capacitance and also the potential difference across each capacitor if the combination is connected to 120 volt. So this problem, these problems are very easy. You can solve these three problems using these formulas discussed above. So thank you.